Warning, do not attempt to follow along this next warning. Warning, this vehicle contains sensory profanity, unrealistic black relays, sweeping things, fanatic explosion, 8-ball pencil song here, eggs, and recycling bins, so that the amount of tragic stuff it would make it go to the far reaches of the galaxy at such epic speeds, the trash would light on fire, despite the lack of oxygen outside our atmosphere, so fast it would override the gravitational pull of planets the size of our sun to the point that the ink of the trash paper would disintegrate with extreme magnitudes.
Hi there, folks. Today I'm going to be looking at some different electronics during the 60s period. And we're going to start off with, I don't know how to say it,
this f***ing thing.
This is the Panasonic NV-HD630, a standard VCR from the late 90s, just when the DVDs were about to take over. The first VCR machine was developed in 1969 by Sony and officially released 2 years later in Tokyo. It used tapes similar to VHS tapes, which would later go on to be the standard format in the next 30 years. Although the new technology was groundbreaking, it came at a hefty price tag of what's equal to over $7,000 to this date. Because of that, it never broke through to the regular consumer market. 10 years later, in 1979, there were two technical standards on the market: the Betamax tape developed by Sony, and the VHS tape developed by JVC. In the end, the Betamax tapes were reduced to a tape only used by professionals, such as movie makers, due to its superior video and arguably audio quality. Around the 2000 year mark, the DVD became popular and would soon make the VHS an obsolete format. Hey, dude, what the f***? Oh god, put on a picture of a DVD, not.
Dude, what the f*** are you doing? Holy sh**.
In just 5 years, DVDs were largely preferred over the VHS, and these days, few consumer customers own a VCR. And already a decade after the DVD was introduced, the Blu-ray format came out, and soon enough, it will outrule the ever-so-popular DVD. Around the early 60s, TVs also became popular, and obviously, you can't have a VCR without a TV, which resulted in TV-VCR combos coming out and predictably failing to succeed. So we just barely scratched the surface of the VCR, but now we'll move on to lasers. Oh yeah, there were lasers back in the 60s, they were under development. Now, unfortunately, I don't have any lasers I can show you. Did you see that? Holy shit. A laser. What exactly is a laser? Well, the one you just saw has nothing to do with lasers, really. Movies would often borrow the word laser for their highly technological light beam ray weapon things, although no real laser can do more than burn through a metal plate. I'm talking about industry lasers, of course. Basically, these are automated lasers, commonly used for cutting through certain metals like aluminum or even steel. However, these lasers are way too powerful for you to play around with, and instead, the consumer market has some very strong handheld lasers to offer, to the point where you could probably melt your face off, assuming you would keep a sustained aim in one spot at a time. Handheld lasers can also pop balloons, light matches, and even burn through duct tape. Handheld lasers often come in a variety of colors. The first laser was constructed at Hughes Research Laboratories by Theodore H. Maiman. The laser was built using the same principle as the so-called maser, with the main difference being that the laser was capable of sustained output while the maser wasn't. The principle of the maser is used in microwaves to this date, which also happened to be its original purpose, hence the name: microwave amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. In other words, the maser. But what exactly is a laser? Well, simply put, a laser is a light source, optically and electrically amplified to a point where it generates high amounts of heat, causing matches to light on fire and even melting rubber. You may think of it as putting a giant lens in front of the sun and concentrating all its light into a small area. Obviously, that area would get devastatingly hot extremely quickly. Kind of a cool metaphor, actually. So my guess is, you currently don't think of lasers as you used to do. Am I right? Well, anywho, it's time to move on. It's time to move on to computers. When we talk about computers, something that comes to mind very quickly is video games. Video games is a prime example of how far the industry has come since, well, let's go back to 1949. This is the EDSAC, one of the first calculators ever. Yeah, this big thing is a calculator. Just like the ones you hold in your hand while you do math in school. Except this one was even worse, and much much bigger. So the calculator may not be very impressive, but pay your respects. It's the core of every computer in every home on the entire planet. Basically, all a computer can do is recognize whether a function is on or if it's off. The number 1 meaning it's off or active, and the number 0 meaning it's off. So even this right here is just a few billions of zeros and ones. Now, obviously, we need something to translate these values, ones and zeros, into something visual. So that's why we have operating systems. Now, to this day, there's a lot of operating systems. We have Windows XP, Vista, Windows 7, and then we have the Macs, and we got Linux. And, well, they're all a little different, but pretty much the same thing. They translate zeros and ones into something we can see and hear. During the 60s, computers started to become transistor-based, which improved them in every which way, including faster processing, smaller power requirements, better reliability, and cheaper production. In 1961, what's considered to be the first dedicated video game came out, Space War. Just from the name, you can guess what it is. A two-player game where the players settled to each their spaceship and gun each other down. You had the ability to move, which would prove necessary because of the black hole in the middle of the screen constantly sucking you towards it. It was simple, but it was the beginning of a new age of entertainment. You can, in fact, go to the internet and look up Space War to find a version ported to our 21st century home computers. After that came many other classics, including the infamous Pong, as well as Pac-Man. What's strange to think about is that it's the exact same thing all along. Zeros and ones. With the invention of the internet later on, the world has changed drastically. Everything there ever was is on the internet. Anything that ever goes onto the internet never goes away. And also, the internet, with its extensive community, has proven to do plenty of good, such as Ted Williams, a homeless man who was given a job, a house, and money within 24 hours of having a video of him and his golden radio voice posted to YouTube. That's all I have about electronics during the 1960s. I'll see you all around, okay?